do want to ask about the Blade anime series. One of the things you always mention is that you're almost surprised at what a reaction Blade gets when you talk about the different animes.
We go to cons, and you know, we say Iron Man, we get a big cheer. We say Wolverine, we get a big cheer. From X-Men, we get a huge cheer. But then when I say Blade, it actually blows up all over the place. And I think that the Blade fans are some of the best Marvel fans that are out there. So if you're a Blade fan, we're at Pride.
Yeah, with the anime projects, that's not really something that speaks to your background. You didn't come up in anime. You came up doing
No, I did. Yeah, exactly.
How has that been, like, kind of like, you know, learning to appreciate this completely different style of storytelling? And
well, I first of all, I have to give a big shout out to Harrison Wilcox and Megan Thomas Bradner, who work for us over at Marvel Television and who basically have been producing that show. And it's been an extraordinary experience. This was a marriage between us and Sony and Madhouse. For those of you that are anime fans, you probably know that Madhouse from such films as Metropolis. But the really strange part, and this is the thing that I'm always amazed when I get to say it, Madhouse Animation actually invented anime.
Right.
And so to me, it's sort of like, wow, like, yeah. Did I invent rock and roll? Or so, if, well, not today.
Okay, all right.
I thought last night, yeah. In the middle of the night, I think I did.
Told some people.
But the Marvel anime, that project was a way for us to be able to sort of explore a larger group, an entire kind of animation that people hadn't really associated with Marvel. It looks spectacular, and that's sort of the cool part about it. So from my point of view, I do have an animation background, so it really was just learning a new language, so
right.
to speak, in terms of how things are.
Yeah. Now we announced, as you said, Harold Perrineau is going to be doing the voice of Blade.
He is?
What do you think Harold's he's a great actor, but has a very distinctive, excellent voice. What does he bring to the character of Blade specifically that attracted you to bring him in?
I think when you think about him from the roles that he plays, he has an attitude. Like, he brings, like, a badass heavyweight kind of, like, this is not a guy you want to mess with. And I think that that's really important, you know, when you start dealing with Blade. Blade is such a rich character, the idea of a daywalker who can, he's a vampire that can go out during the day and at the same time be able to take on, you know, vampires and werewolves. And, you know, he's an odd part about his character is that he's hunting his own kind. Because
yeah.
He's a half vampire himself.
And as you said, there's going to be vampires, there's going to be werewolves. Is this going to have more of a horror feel?
It is. It's a little darker than some of the other ones that we've been doing. What's super cool about it is because it takes place in the Pacific Rim area, you do get to see kind of new kinds of monsters, like something that has kind of a Japanese influence to it. And, you know, if you think about, you know, really where some of the cool horror comes out of, Japan really does bring it. And
absolutely.
So, you know, I think folks will see an edge to Blade that you haven't seen in some of the other ones.
Jumping back to X-Men, which does premiere this Friday.
Cool.
G4, 11 o'clock. Similarly, how does the sort of different style, placing it in the anime world, and as you said, placing it in a different part of the world geographically, how does that affect the X-Men story?
Well, I think one of the things that, you know, what's terrific about the X-Men is that they are an international cast. You've got characters from, you know, all around the world, whether it's Storm from Africa or Colossus from Russia, you know, and Wolverine does have, you know, inherently in his story, you know, from that great story with Chris Claremont and Frank Miller, you know, Japan is part of the world that he's been in. We've just finished seeing a huge adventure with Logan and Wolverine that all took place in Japan. So bringing them back there is very cool. And, you know, there's actually an extremely large cast that we're having an awful lot of fun with. Emma Frost will be there. The character of Armor, for those of you that are fans from that character, is going to be there. So it's a unique group and a big adventure, and I think that's part of what makes the X-Men so cool.
This is somewhat based, not directly, but this does have elements of the Phoenix Saga.
It does. What as you'll see next Friday night, the story begins at the end of the Dark Phoenix story.
Okay.
So that has a profound effect on what happened to Scott. He's lost Jean, the Phoenix has sort of broken up the team, and then something amazing, astonishing, uncanny.
Amazing's the other one.
I guess. Something uncanny happens.
Yes.
That forces Xavier to bring the band back together again, and they go off on this pretty spectacular adventure.
Marvel, your universe.